surgery in the Academy of Ambulatory Foot and Ankle Surgery. Today I want to show you a very interesting case where a patient had a chronic reoccurring lesion under the fifth metatarsal. Of course, this is a common deformity we all see. She had a standard surgery done with a partial metatarsal head resection. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that surgery. That's a great surgery. I've done a lot of those in the past myself. I don't do those now. I'll do it a different way. But I'll show you the reason why in her foot it didn't work. If we look at her x-ray, you can see the procedure that she had done before was basically a partial metatarsal head resection. So what we did with her, we went behind this area and performed a little osteotomy, which you can see lateral here. We did this minimally invasive to kind of pull her foot up. And we also performed a gastroc recession on her. And this is very important because the patient had gastroc equinus, and you have to address this in patients that have forefoot issues, especially metatarsalgia type issues, because that's one of the etiologies of the pain. Okay, we're going to examine the patient now and show what her foot type looks like. If you look at her foot type and get her in root neutral subtalar joint casting position, if you test her rear foot, she has a lot of movement in her rear foot. Her rear foot goes past vertical in both the supinatory inversion stance. So she has a flexible rear foot. She also has a flexible forefoot in the same position loaded. If you look at her first ray, it goes above and below the fifth metatarsal with the forefoot loaded. For this patient, if you look at her foot type, take a look at her foot type over here, and you see she appears to have a high arch. You might even call that a cavus foot. But her foot is not a cavus foot. Her foot has a lot of mobility. She actually has a flexible rear foot, flexible forefoot. So to treat this patient, you have to be careful performing just metatarsal osteotomies or any other type of metatarsal procedure, or you'll get transfer lesions. Her biggest etiology was she has gastroc equinus. So what we did with her, she originally had a partial fifth metatarsal head recession. What we did was went just proximal to that, made a percutaneous incision, performed an osteotomy in the metatarsal here to lift it up a little, and also performed a gastroc recession, which we did mid-calf here, approximately 16 centimeters or so above the Achilles tendon insertion. And this is done slightly, slightly medial to the sural nerve. And sometimes we go all the way through the gastroc here, sometimes partial, depending on the patient we're looking at. So now I want to show you her now. This is 6 months later. Her lesions have resolved. Her forefoot pain has resolved completely. And even with her own movement, look how much movement now she can get up on her foot. She goes way past the normal 10 degrees. And even with kind of aggressive motion here with helping her here, she can see how much more she gets up now. So before this surgery, she was getting to about zero, and that was it. So this has now taken all the pressure off of her forefoot, and her pain has now subsided. So we're going to actually talk to our patient now. Now, how long have you had forefoot pain? When did it start for you?
About 8 years ago.
And then from that, you had the surgery done on the fifth metatarsal.
Surgery, I wore cast for 6 months.
Wore cast for 6 months after that. Now, that surgery, it did relieve it to some degree, right? That traditional procedure, did you have relief? It still bothered you.
Yes.
So that's one of the issues. If you do a surgery, whether you do it traditional or with minimally invasive surgery, if you've got gastroc equinus, you need to address that. So now what we did was address that. So let me ask you this. Now in the last 6 months since we've done your surgery, obviously you have some post-op recovery, but is your foot hurting now?
No.
So you're completely pain-free?
No.
Do you even think about your foot during the day?
Except, no.
Except for your ingrown nail.
Exactly.
So that's, you've got an ingrown nail we've got to deal with, but we'll do that here in the office. But here's the thing. What we're trying to do is get patients pain-free that have metatarsalgia. And you have to look at a lot of different parameters. There's a lot of things that cause metatarsalgia. If gastroc equinus is one of the etiologies that has to be addressed, if you just do your forefoot work, it's not going to work. Also, you have to look at transverse plane deformities. Some of these patients require subtalar joint stenting. If you just do forefoot work and neglect your rear foot work in certain foot types, the forefoot work is going to be less likely to work. You're going to have more chance of getting transverse lesions and increased pain, and your surgeries may not work. So I just want to share that with you today.